I'd love to introduce to you the director of this show, the wickedly talented Angela Miller.
Thank you all so much for coming. Before I go any further, I'd like you to meet the rest of the incredible staff that helped make this whole thing. Introduce the world premiere, second night, of Axel Falls, A New Kind of Musical.
Angela for that wonderful curtain speech. And thank you all out there for coming. This show is called Axel Falls, or Tarrytown, USA, a new kind of musical. It takes place in the distant year of 2018, as if someone imagined what 2018 might look like back in the 1970s. The world is similar to how you see it today, but with some exciting advancements. Tyler, change these lights. I don't like them. Actors! Can you get to places, please? Our story takes place in a small town called Axel Falls, hence the title of our show. Perhaps you've been there before, or somewhere just like it. To help you get to know our town a little better, here's our opening number.
Like, I was a reason for her getting laid off. It just got me thinking why I was there instead of her because she was way more experienced than I was, having just graduated college. After that, I kept my head down, laid low. I didn't want to get in the way or cost someone their way of life for, well, me. Not like it mattered. It's not like I kept my job in the end.
To be upset.
See you tomorrow.
I know you're still new at this, but we can't afford to make mistakes with orders anymore.
I'm sorry. I haven't had to work 15 years, so I'm a little too remembering how to do all this.
Portia has only been working here a few days. I hired her as a favor to her wife.
That's me.
As I was saying, I hired her as a favor to her wife, who's the CEO of the tire company that has single-handedly kept me in business all these years. Tough times affect everyone. Even the people on top.
Well, I'll be going first. Axel Tire Company, of which I am the CEO, has been manufacturing and distributing tires since 1898.
Actually, Miss Steele, it was 1897.
Anyways, Axel Falls has always been a tire town. It's ingrained in our identity, and it's the reason we've thrived for all these years. Back when I served as mayor, we were even honored for our long-standing service to the automotive industry.
Due to a worldwide push for reusable energy and cleaner air,
which we were all very grateful for because the ozone layer, she was going down.
Right. Due to a worldwide push for reusable energy and cleaner air, in 2006, a Swedish scientist developed a totally clean and sustainable hover car,
which led to the mass production of hover cars around the world, and a more restricted and heavily taxed production of grounded vehicles and rubber cars, which wasn't good for, you know, tires.
Initially, when the other tire companies started going out of business, that meant more money for me. Now we're the last tire company manufacturing rubber tires in the world.
But business has been back in a decline since more than 98% of the population are in hover vehicles, and the bank won't give us the money we need to stay afloat.
You would think the tire industry would be pretty secure, but not anymore. It's no longer a question of if they'll close down, it's when.
Where was such an important feat in human engineering? It changed the world. Did you ever hear someone joke about how you can't reinvent the wheel? Well, someone actually reinvented the wheel. These weren't the first people in town to lose their jobs to changing times. I used to do security until the computerized security systems just got better than humans. Fewer errors.
We're old-fashioned, but we're not out of fashion. We were one of the first towns to have a fully automated fast food restaurant.
Look, times change. You either catch up or get left behind. I guess we all just didn't realize things would change so quickly.
That should be about all you need to know for now. The rest we can catch you up on a little later on.
When I first came to Axel Falls, I almost missed the exit. It was not what I was expecting. I don't mean that in a negative way, it was just very different from where I'm from. I grew up in a big city, on the cusp of the next tech boom. We were one of the first places to implement citywide holographic interfacing, and of course, we were always the first to utilize new hover technology when it was released. This trip was honestly the first time in years I'd seen a car on wheels with my own two eyes. I guess I took this all for granted growing up? I don't know. I do know that this progress and evolution inspired me to spread this to others, to tell the stories of those leading these advancements. That's why I came here, to Axel Falls, the last tire town. I was hoping to tell the story about how a town stuck in its old ways would go on to become one of the leading innovators of the future. But the story I got was even better. Not only were they on the forefront of hover technology, but boy can they write an earworm of a song. Keep an eye out for them.
All the way back in 1897, space invaders hit arcades around the world. Over the next few decades, games, Pac-Man, Street Fighter, Time Crisis, they're all iconic. Then, in 2002, at the height of home gaming revolution, new virtual reality gaming experience came straight to your home. As more gamers logged into their new worlds, our kids around the country were getting unplugged, which brings us here to my favorite place there's ever been, right off of Main Street, our arcade. Back then, Axel Falls was a harsh reality. Things were only going to get worse before they got better. People were losing their jobs. The kids in town were looking for an escape, so we came here to an alternate reality arcade.
You're going down, Dave. I got this damn call.
That's what you've been saying for the past 10 years.
Well, yeah, ever since you made it one day to college, you've been a little rusty.
Fine, round.
Up, up, down, down, left, right, B-A, pew! It broke again?
Sixth machine this week.
I guess you'll never find out that you lost.
I brought $10 on this game.
Sorry, Lottie, all bets are final. Now taking back
bets on which machine to break down next.
Cut it out. It just needs the old reboot.
It's beyond repair. Home anyway.
Home is so not home anymore.
Ever since the layoffs, my mom is exhausted. She's taking more hours and I don't see her anymore.
Lucky for you all, I got a surprise right off the run. Fresh from Maristate, the visually immersive recreational techno-universal augmented lens. But you can just call it the lens, the Virtua 5000 lens.
No, definitely not. Not in my arcade.
Aunt Allie, you've really got to start installing more VR games here.
We're the only people ever in here. Don't you want more business?
You know what I always said.
Donkey Kong is the greatest game ever.
No, the other thing.
Everything goes downhill after college.
No, the other thing. Throw away the glasses, give me the classics.
You've literally never said that before.
Well, I'm saying it now. All this technology can get to our heads. It's important to stay grounded and remember where we came from. And I made that decision when I made this place. No virtual reality in the alternate reality. In hindsight, I probably just should have caved to the VR and maybe I could have stayed open a little bit longer. Pride before the fall. Well, anyways, everything happens for a reason. I put on the goggles once, tried it out. It was cool, but nothing beats the classics.
Hey everyone! My dad got laid off.
Okay, why don't we all head on home now? Megan? Do you want to talk about it?
There's nothing to talk about.
Well, I sure could use some help around here. I mean, machines have been breaking down left and right, and I know how good your dad is at fixing stuff.
You want my dad to work here?
Well, yeah, I mean, the old reboot hasn't really been working lately, and I could use someone with technical skills. Have him stop by.
Thank you for always being there.
Anytime.
I guess the hardest part about being fired was the fact that I just didn't have anything to do anymore. I used to have a routine. I used to innovate every day. I used to be a part of a family. Now, I found myself on the outside of that family. Fired and betrayed by the very people that I grew up with. They couldn't even look me in the eyes anymore. I know it wasn't anything personal, but at the time, it certainly felt like I was being singled out, especially when everybody else who was let go was able to move on and grow. Rodrigo was almost immediately hired at the alternate reality arcade, and even though I knew Alina's situation was by no means easy, stung that she was given a second chance with her performance review, and I was left in the dust. I had so many great ideas back then, but nobody listened or cared. I can't help but wonder what would have happened if somebody had believed in me the way that they did Rodrigo or Alina. Things eventually got better, but those first few months were really difficult.
Leaving work the day of the performance review talk, there was a lot going through my head. The easiest way to sum it up is through the five stages of grief. Denial. I couldn't believe what I was just told. The worst employee at the factory? There's no way. Someone just got hired, and I can't even remember her name, so there's no way that she is better than me. I mean, okay, maybe I missed a few days last month, and maybe I've been late for like the past 2 weeks, but there's no way that I had the lowest performance review. Anger. You know what? I never even liked this job. I only applied because I thought I would be able to test drive the tires and not make them. I hated every minute of it. I went through months and months of training for nothing. Bargaining. Maybe if I just pick up more shifts or maybe if I just work harder, they'll see my worth. And as I was grieving my way home, I walked by Reinventing the Wheel, a tire repurposing shop on the outskirts of town. Unfortunately, Didi and Anjin saw me and lured me in.
How's it hanging, Alina?
Wait, don't answer that. Look at what Didi and I just finished.
It's a robotic tire dog. Don't you like it? Isn't it far out? Isn't it revolutionary?
You mean tire-lutionary? Give me some skin.
Oh my gosh, I am so sorry. I broke it. Now you have to throw it away and start all over. I'm so sorry.
Broken?
Throw it away!
No, no,
know, right?
You see from the broken, we see something better. Cut it, burn it, twist it, fix it, and got a new trendsetter. You see something shattered, but we see something cheater.
Something that helps people and, well, tires are self-essential and useful. on the tire.
Oh my god, that's so funny.
But now the hovercraft was made in 1388, a considerable amount of business away from us.
And as the greatest saleswoman in the entire world.
Yeah. Oh, I felt very offended. You know, the only thing keeping me from having a nervous breakdown was my great community, my scented candles, and my daily vanilla frappuccino with rainbow bunko. Things around here have gotten really gloomy. I just couldn't stand it anymore. I had to do something. I guess you can say I added some sprinkles on top of that.
Rise and shine, everyone. We have a lot to do today.
Define a lot to do today.
If I have to check the consistency of rubber one more time.
Can I steal a word?
No, we have no time for that, Alexa. What's the morning rundown?
Here's what I found on morning runs. Find a good pair of sneakers that fit you well. Make sure they're tight.
No, Alexa, that's not what I meant. What's today's agenda?
Here's what I found for a price for agendas. For $18.97, you can get an agenda.
No, Alexa, not what I meant. Left to do. Nobody's buying grounded cars anymore. Nobody's buying tires anymore.
Nobody needs us.
Are you clocked in? And that means you're on my payroll, so you better find something to do, even if that means refilling the soap in the bathroom.
Miss Steele, the lavender soap you requested were just
Oh, Alexa!
Miss Steele.
Alexa!
Yes, Miss Steele, how may I assist you?
Scared to go, but you got me.
good song. Clearly, how this town was such a tight-knit community that was truly dedicated to each other in the way of life. How strange it is to see something like that when you're from the city, a place where there typically aren't those kinds of connections. I must have been handed at least 15 flyers that day, but it didn't matter. Obviously, I didn't have a car to put tires on, and secondly, no amount of sales would keep that company from going under in the long run. Change is hard for everyone, and the way you react can have just as much of an impact. They simply didn't understand that the livelihoods would become obsolete. That made my job so much harder, especially in the beginning.
I earned a master's degree in advanced robotics from California Tech. It was the most rigorous and challenging time of my life, but it was also rewarding. My final project and dissertation were up to my discretion. The committee thought it would be better for my mind that way. My dissertation detailed how, in the medical field, it was possible to replace lost organs with robots. I was right. I was my final project. I was my greatest creation. Since then, nothing I have ever done professionally has been as challenging or as rewarding. Don't get me wrong, I was grateful for the opportunities that I got, but I had a family now. Someone to take care of. The town, the factory, the arcade. They weren't cutting it. I had to find a way. I needed to provide a future for my daughter. If I was my greatest creation, then she was ours.
Thanks for letting me escape for a bit. I miss the good old days when I could just stay here all day. What a trip.
No, the store is always open, unless it's after 10 p.m. on weeknights. 9 to 4 on weekends. Yes, 4 p.m. I do actually have a life outside of these walls. Don't be a stranger.
And done! 3 seconds, that's a new personal record. Did you ever check to see if the Galaga machine was actually plugged into the wall? Because it wasn't plugged in.
These things have plugs.
Oh my god, Galaga's working again? Sweet! Humanoids, come on, let's play!
Everyone, our new comic is finally finished. Your day's about to get so much better.
Check this out. We present to you
Watch How Axel Falls, a satirical comic.
Based on true events.
That are also fictional.
This one's called The Blame Game.
Wow. That's hilarious.
Mrs. Stealing our livelihood.
The chain of command.
Whoa, you guys drew these?
Wow, guys, that was so spot on. Don't you think it was a little insensitive?
How is it insensitive? It's an accurate representation of what's going on right now.
Accurate? It's over-exaggerated. It's not Mrs. Steele's fault that the tire industry is collapsing. I bet she didn't want to let anyone go.
If it's that over-exaggerated, then why is it going on in our daily lives right now? Besides, if Miss Steele actually cared for her employees, she would have had a better plan.
Who plans for something like this?
The government. We probably have chips in our brain. We have all the technology. Like those chip readers to track your lost dog, pills for food, mood patches, clothes that dress themselves. The earth is flat.
I thought the comic was crazy.
You know what I always say, go big or go home. On that note, it's time to go home. See you in the morning.
Bye, Ellie.
You
coming?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll catch up with you. Go home without me.
Sir.
Everything's up and running. Done for the day.
Thanks for bringing life back to this old dump. I know the kids can be overwhelming, but you gotta love them.
It was a little annoying when they started playing with the bionic eye, but whatever. It's not like it actually hurt.
I think we need this place just as much as they do.
Hey, I need to ask you something.
Spill.
Have you ever put so much effort into making something move forward, only to find that you're spinning in the mud?
I have.
It's just, I've gone down this path for so long, but it's just gotten muddier, and I can't see where it goes anymore. Maybe it's time for me to shift gears.
I know what you mean.
don't get me wrong, I appreciate everything you've done for my daughter and I, but it just might be time for us to move on.
I understand, just don't lose sight of what's important. I wish I had followed my own advice.
Yeah. back.
It took longer than I would have liked to get an interview with the CEO of Axle Tire Company. She was uniquely adept at avoiding me. However, I eventually got a hold of her assistant and was able to ask the both of them a few questions.
We haven't much time.
Right. So, the last tire company in the world. That must put a lot of pressure on you and your employees.
No pressure.
No pressure? Didn't you recently lay off 2/3 of your workforce?
They weren't performing up to our standards.
Would you ever consider implementing automated technology in your factory to replace your remaining employees?
No, never. Our philosophy is don't fix it if it isn't broken.
Just because something isn't broken doesn't mean it can't be improved.
What was this interview about again?
Hey, my work isn't concerned with where you were or where you are. I want to know where you're going.
So let's talk about that before my boss gets going.
Business is suffering, grounded vehicles are virtually obsolete, and rubber manufacturing is taxed nearly into oblivion. What do you see for the future of Axle Tire Company?
I see us going back in time and singing Kumbaya with the troglodytes of the past while riding my pet dinosaur Fluffy.
All right, we're done here.
Thank you for your time.
Yeah, you're welcome.
It wasn't my worst interview. Now it'll be a powerful thing.
Documentary for a while now, but tonight was the night where everything finally came into focus. Let's head over to Reinventing the Wheel, where earlier you met Dee Dee and Anjean. They're the ones who like to repurpose things. Not my type of thing, but they were successful. I've lived in town my whole life, and I've never been in their store once. Once a week, all the old folks in town like to get together for a poker game. They didn't play much poker.
All I'm saying is, if I were to pick the next place in town to go under, it'd be that busted arcade.
That arcade is the only reason I got through my childhood.
There are far worse places the young people in our town could go than that arcade. That everybody thinks it's fun to spend the time flipping tires. You're just mad. I beat you in tire flipping at Dunlop Day 5 years straight.
You were
Dunlop Day is the annual harvest festival here in Axle Falls. Oh, I'm getting old. For the better part of a century, the folks of this town have gotten together and celebrated their rich history. It's a pretty big deal.
You were the tire flipping champion?
The very first.
When it comes to flipping tires, this man sees red. When it comes to human interaction, however, this cheese weasel makes us see red.
What do you guys think about people in town saying that this might be our last Dunlop Day?
Who's saying that? They say that every year, those chumps.
Little did we know that it would be the last Dunlop Day, at least the way it used to be.
If it is the last year, then that's a real shame. That's the one thing that brings this town together, and we could really be brought together right now.
In your own words, why is Dunlop Day so important?
Well, it's got games, food, entertainment, tires, and good vibes. You know, the festival is where I had my first pop-up shop.
That pop-up shop is how we met. She was wearing a groovy pair of tire earrings, and I had to be a part of that.
My entire legacy is at that festival. If I have nothing in this world, I have my records. Tire flipping, champion. Tire tossing, champion. Most rolls downhill inside of a tire, champion. Sit down, old man.
What about you? Your father founded this festival, and you're mayor for so many of them.
It's always been a time for the community to come together, where they can forget about the stressful things in life, forget about work, and just be one big happy family. And we really need that right now.
Okay. What if this is the last Dunlop Day? What would you like to see happen?
It won't be. Even if we aren't Tire Town USA anymore, we'll still be Axle Falls and we'll still find reasons to come together.
Even if we have to reinvent ourselves.
No matter what, I have a feeling this Dunlop Day will be one to remember.
And it was.
In the grand scheme of things, all the free time I found myself with after I was let go really allowed me to explore what I wanted to be.
celebrated, I'd do some crazy things back then. I remember starting a theater troupe and trying to direct a musical for the town's Dunlop Day. That was rough. You'll see. I would like to apologize in advance for that. But it did teach me that I like to be in charge of both myself and others, something that would become invaluable to my future. The moment that I changed my mindset was because of that experience. I was in the right place at the right time when I first saw a hover car up close, and that opened up a world of opportunities for me. I know that their arrival probably left the town feeling threatened, but I couldn't help but think about how I could use the speed and safety of hover cars to my advantage. It's when I thought of my business, Food on the Fly. I know that changes can be difficult for a lot of people, and they were for me at first too, but I am proud of the fact that I turned a really hard time for myself to something positive.
Mommy,
all right, I'd like quiet, please. I would like to run the scene from the top. I will wait. Thank you. Now, Dunlop Day is only 5 days away and rehearsal is almost over. Theater has never been a part of Dunlop Day before. 3 weeks ago, not a single word of this existed. We wrote every word. We composed every note. We choreographed every dance. Together, we created the history of Axel Falls, a really good musical. Now, I would like to run this from the top. Remember, these are real people who really matter to our town's history. Tell their story. For us. For you. For them. Places.
Hello. It is me, Axel Johnson. What time is that? I cannot tell you because we do not have wristwatches in 1897.
This is a wheel. Wheels are important, right?
Right. I came to this town that does not have a name yet, from far away, but my tire broke. If only there was a way that my tire would not crack.
Oh. It was Dana Falls.
No, 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 that is not your line. Just keep going.
I am Dana Falls.
Look, a nice mnemonic, rubber.
That was me. Rubber and wheels? Talk about besties.
Put it together and what have you got?
Let's start a factory!
Johnson, Dana Falls created Axel Falls, or as it's come to be known, Tire Town, USA.
Don't you think people will get tired of tires?
Well, no! Our first song is Tire Traction, Major Action, a 5, 6, 7, and...
Wow. Breathtaking work, truly. I can't wait to see you all on the New York stage.
Excuse me. Can we help you?
No, we can help you. We're from the Hover Brother Hover Company.
HBHC.
And we've heard a thing or two about Axel Falls, the town of yesterday. We're here to make you the town of tomorrow. Go, go. Right here, please. Thank you. Yes, right there. Yes, you can just stand. Yes, thank you.
You live in a world where what we find is the place to be on par with what I am.
The life that you live in is essentially expired. There's nothing new to do. You
what you need. It's a hover car, we're moving on, we've raised the bar.
It's been great!
A hover car, your dreams come true, you'll sure take star.
Make a wish!
You'll go so far, the future is now! Imagine a world where we defy gravity, sticking stuck in the ground. Man, that's a tragedy. Everyone's evolving and moving on rapidly. If you won't change, you're living in a fantasy.
Thank you.
I'll go get some.
What happened? What's wrong with this machine?
Sorry.
It was your fault. Thanks, Rachel. All right, then.
On the side of the machine. Why were you even hired in the first place if you can't do this job?
You know how many of my friends I had to watch walk out of the door just to see you walk in here and take their place? Too many.
I'm sorry, truly. I'll just leave.
No. Come, all of you. This was an accident. We're all exhausted. We're all overworked. Any one of us could have done this.
Mom, it's okay.
No, it's not.
Yeah. You know, it is. This is what I signed up for. I'm a risk taker. Check it out, I still have the scar. It's okay.
It doesn't matter. She was in the room. She has to go.
What's going on here? Get back to work.
All right, everyone. Workplace injuries are common and are no cause for
concern. No cause for concern? Look, that machine is broken. We can't afford to fix this.
Steel, it's a machine. Let's just check on Twiggy and make sure she's okay.
No, I want to know who's responsible for this. Anyone slowing this down is a liability. We can't afford to keep her on here.
Who did this? Who is responsible for this?
I thought you all loved this company.
It was an accident.
What?
It was an accident.
Is this true?
Yes.
I advise each and every one of you to proceed with caution, because somebody's gonna have to pay for this, and it's not going to be me. I always try to see the best in everyone,
but they don't make glasses strong enough for that one.
Thank you. You really didn't have to do that.
It was an accident, and we have to stick together. Let's just go back to work.
Time to flag fire!
down and got a call from HPHCHQ saying that we needed to sell more hover cars or whatever. And Kelly, with an E, wasn't much help.
My contract doesn't mention sales once. I don't know how Robbie got Danger Dan to believe that that was part of my job, but he did.
But back to the main character of the story, I mean, me. I had the Herculean task, write that down, of getting these people who are comfortable being sad and dirty and on the ground to hop into hover cars.
I'm all about making a big entrance, and we were selling those hover cars to the best of our ability, but stepping on toes wasn't getting us anywhere.
And I just learned so much since being here. Like, did you know that, like, while everyone who grew up in a town does have buck teeth, it's just so that they can open soda bottles. Sorry, my vibrator said that's so strong. I just got a notification from my Daily Buddha app, and I just think it applies perfectly here. It says, sometimes things must change, so you must change. Ancient proverb.
He said that?
It's just wisdom delivered straight to your phone. Wow.
Wow. Looking back, I really do think we went about it all wrong. While we were trying to help, we just ended up causing more of a problem.
She said that? You know, the thing about Kelly is that she's just so good at thinking. I mean, like, I guess it's possible that she was right or whatever, but I'm not gonna get into it.
I've tried to pitch so many new ideas for the company, but Danger Dan never listens to me. You know, I've been working there for over 5 years, and I'm still his assistant. Honestly, I'm kind of just fed up with this company. Like, I feel so overwhelmed recently. No,
what does this have to do with how hovercrafts affect the environment?
It doesn't, but I can answer that for you. Creating infrastructure for hover cars doesn't require deforestation, because hover cars can levitate over the land, and that's just one of the ways.
So, what's this video for again?
It's my final project for film school. I figured there'd be something interesting here in the last tire town.
What school do you go to? USC, UWS, NYU, PCU?
You probably never heard of it.
One chai latte, order up.
Yay, Portia, you finally got it.
I got it. Can have it.
No, you take it. What I really wanted to say was, take your hover car company out of my town.
No, you take it. What I really wanted to say is that it was only a matter of time before you go out of business. On me.
No, you haven't taken us out of business just yet.
It was right then and there that it all kind of clicked into place for me. I've never really vibed a small town life before, but I don't know, something about this town and these hardworking people just gave me an idea. You know, we could actually make a really good team. Let's have a meeting, you and I. I'd like to talk to you a bit more about the Hubble Brothers.
We knew we had to do something about the hover situation,
so we decided to take matters into our own hands. Our friends were angry, we were angry. The town was in such crisis, we didn't think anyone would notice or care about something so small.
We always try to make light of serious situations.
It wasn't always appreciated, but we thought it was funny.
You'll see how the rest of Axel Falls reacts when we reveal our greatest creation yet.
Citizens of Axel Falls to the 75th annual Dunlop Day. I am so excited to see everybody back together again. Your devotion to this town is inspiring. Now, the moment you've all been waiting for, our world-renowned tire roll. Contestants, grab your tires. If you don't know the rules, you're about to find out. Ready, set, roll!
Gather round at the heart of Axel Falls.
good tradition. It's so sweet to see a town that looks forward to watching tires roll. Holding on to the past is so heartwarming. There's nothing quite like the present, or better yet, the future. Thank you so much for welcoming us into your beautiful town of Axel Falls. Your generosity and kindness has inspired the Hover Brothers Hover Company to give a little something back.
We at HBHC have decided to give you an opportunity to win big. We will be raffling off our newest hover car model, and only one lucky contestant will win. This is an opportunity so extraordinary, it just might take your simple little lives to new heights.
On behalf of the Hover Brothers Hover Company, we wish you luck.
So, when do you think the shop's closing for good?
What? The shop's never gonna close. We've had financial struggle with the shop.
We've been through it.
I'm getting through
it. I'm not so sure. I saw Daniel coming out of the office this morning. He put it in his truck.
This festival used to be sacred, and now this hover company is invading all aspects of our lives. Hey, are you gonna enter in the raffle?
I don't know. I was thinking about it, but never really win much of anything. Hover car could help get my business started, though. It's a food delivery service, but using a hover car.
I love food!
You should do it. It might be worth it to test your luck. You're right. Here goes nothing. This is ridiculous.
This raffle's like feeding bacon to a pig.
That's right, Rob. Robbie. And just when you thought Dunlop Day could not get any more exciting...
Can't wait to hear this one.
We are pleased to announce that the Hover Brothers Hover Company will continue to expand with the recent acquisition of Axel Tire Company. Now, come on, Miss Steele. Get on up here. None of this would have been possible without Miss Steele's hard work and dedication to all of her loyal employees. You all have her to thank for this amazing opportunity. Come on, let's give it up for the woman of the hour.
What just happened?
Mercedes, what did he do?
This is what's best for the town, honey. Don't worry about it, we're gonna be loaded!
Axel Falls will no longer be a town of the past. The future is now.
And if you didn't get a hover car today, there's more where that came from at the Hover Brothers Hover Company. Remember, the door to the future is always open.
Hover cars have got to go, hey, hey! Ho, ho! Hover cars have got to go, hey, hey! Ho, ho! Hover cars!
I got it. Yeah, I got it.
Thank you, Laura.
title of the protest following the announcement of Hover Brothers Cover Company acquisition of Axle Tire Company.
That's a good photo.
Thanks.
It's so good, in fact, that my company bought the image and ran it with the article I eventually wrote about this place. This is one of the defining images of the public's perception of Axle Falls.
Photography is a form of time travel. With great images, you can look back and feel like what it was like to be there. You can hear the crowd and be there for a moment you weren't there for.
Each of these people had a story to tell, and it was our job to share them with the world.
Nobody officially organized the event. Shortly after the announcement that the Hover Brothers were permanently setting up shop in town, folks just started gathering.
It was just a group conversation at first, and then the chanting began.
Hey, hey, hey! Ho, ho! Hover cars have got to go! Hey, hey! Ho, ho! Hover cars have got to go!
We are a tire town, not a hover town!
Pretty sure some of the people didn't even know what they were protesting.
It was the loudest I've ever heard of.
I didn't know Mercedes had come today. She got air from me when she got home that night.
And a billboard.
Oh yes, the billboard.
I thought it was hilarious.
I thought it was really poor taste.
Nobody will ever agree on that billboard.
It was an emotional day. The worst part is we knew we couldn't really make any change.
It was sort of beautiful though.
You can't prevent something that's already happened.
I was proud of our town that day. We didn't get what we wanted, but we didn't lose any more than we had to.
Tire factories are now extinct.
Selfishly, I was only thinking of me and my business.
Its residents had been raised in Weber. In the moment the acquisition was announced, it was an instant identity crisis for Axle Falls.
Axle Falls wouldn't come together like this for a long time. But what else happened at the protest? That's for you guys to fill in.
I didn't participate in the protest that day. For a long time, I carried a lot of guilt about that fact. It wasn't that I didn't stand with my community. I always have, and I still do, but I just want a hover car. I was about to start one of the most innovative and successful companies of the 21st century. Food on the fly. A delivery service that would drop food right on your doorstep. My life was changing. Rapidly and for the better. Now that I had a purpose, I set about growing my business. Didn't expect it to be so popular so soon, but people loved the idea of getting their favorite foods without having to leave the comfort of their own homes. My business was limited only by the appetites of these customers, and orders were piling on. Couldn't do it alone.
Once HBHC merged with Axle Tire Company, my help wasn't quite needed. I had so many great ideas for the company, but Danger Dan would never listen to some low-life assistant. I felt useless, expendable. As time went on pushing these hover cars and axle falls, something wasn't clicking. Until one day, I saw this simple flyer. Innovators wanted. Tomorrow is today. Join food on the fly. Did I want to be delivering food? No. Did I want to finally start using hover cars for good? You betcha. This is where I knew my assistance would be appreciated.
Production needs to move faster!
The acquisition was great for my daughter and I. HBHC hired me on as floor manager since a
someone capable of designing and maintaining these vehicles. We were able to stay in Axel Falls, the place my daughter loves and grew up in. My new job made me feel like I was doing something rewarding and challenging again. The pay was good, too. HBHC was the miracle I was looking for.
HBHC, how can I assist you? Yes, this is the Axel Falls branch. Would you like me to direct you to the Columbus branch, the Salina branch, Brooklyn branch, the Oscar Shaw branch, Loma branch? Hello? Are you still there? Oh my god, this was the fifth time this week!
Ooh. You missed a spot. In that moment, it took everything in my power not to hit him with a broom. As you can see, there's been a little bit of a role reversal here in the factory. Rodrigo was hired as floor manager, while I was hired to clean the floor he managed.
Coffee break!
Actually, that won't be necessary. We've installed caffeine patch dispensers in the break room, so our employees don't need to waste billable hours drinking coffee. You're stopping by, though. Anyways, while I have all of your attention, I'd like to share some great news. Business is doing great. HBHC is booming. With that having said, we need you to pick up the pace. This is not just a small town tire shop anymore. We're supplying hover cars to the entire world, and it's time for you to rise to the occasion.
You're all doing great, though. I'm here if you have any questions or just want to talk about the transition.
Keep it up, guys. Your work has been flawless. We've created you.
I can't believe that just happened. Who does Danger Dan think he is? The Flying Saucer is going out of business because people have been coming in way less than they used to, and we aren't even allowed to supply coffee to the workers on breaks anymore. What are we gonna do?
I have an idea.
Yeah? Spit it out.
What if we host open mic night at the Flying Saucer? We can accept donations and also boost morale of this town.
Portia, that's a great idea. We've hosted open mic nights in the past to raise money for Dunlop Days. The fundraisers have been huge successes. Let's get to work. We have a lot of preparation to do.
My God, can you guys just stop? I'm sick and tired of listening to you complain. If you'd stop talking for just 2 seconds, you'd come to realize that the pros of the situation outweigh the cons. If the acquisition didn't happen, we'd all be unemployed. It also doesn't hurt that our salaries have increased and we're making way much more money than we were when we were making tires.
She's right. I mean, I'm finally making enough money to live comfortably with my daughter.
Yeah, if you're comfortable living off of blood money.
Shh! You don't know what you're talking about!
If any of you are dissatisfied, you know where the door is.
Come on, guys. Let's get back to work. We're on payroll.
Of course I sold the company. I've never seen so many zeros in my life.
Ever since you sold the company, the Flying Saucer really suffered.
Baby, we're rolling an 8-figure dough. What do you care about a tiny coffee shop?
I took that job because your company was failing. You burned that company to the ground. I just didn't realize when I sold my job. It was my home. And now that Mercedes home every day, I need it out. It was a whole lot of...
Alexa, what should I do my first day of retirement?
Alexa isn't working anymore. I needed a Flying Saucer, and the Flying Saucer needed me. I felt valued there, but what I really wanted was to go buy a home. Anything that wouldn't be too much to ask for.
I thought finding a partner would have been a lot harder.
But the timing was perfect. Even though I was done with
HBHC, I still knew a thing or two about the logistics of business and marketing. The perfect partnership.
I had a small idea, and without her, I never would have been able to sustain it.
The business was genius, and I knew it was going to take the world by storm.
Picture this. Night, you're craving some fries, then food on the fly.
It's good to have green, like a pair of self-made wings. Cause when you're flying high, it's easier to hide. Cause we're on cloud nine. And we're never coming down. Building up the brand, got a new cash flow. The bank can't hold all this dinero. Oh, business is booming, it's booming. Living our best life and we ain't gonna stop. It's the icing on the cake, the cherry on top. Oh, business is booming, it's zooming, it's shaking, it's faking. Business is booming.
It was just supposed to be a joke.
Tire Town USA changed to Retire Town USA.
We added an R, an E, and a D, and everyone was seeing red about it.
Only three letters that ever gave us more trouble than the SAT.
McDonald and Jim Youngman, who made headlines with a billboard of their own in Seattle in 1971.
Following the Vietnam War, the Boeing Aircraft Company fired 70,000 of its workers in the Seattle area.
Seattle had essentially built its entire economy around the Boeing Company, so when workers were laid off, everyone suffered.
This ringing any bells for you?
I don't know about you, but it sounds like a good idea for a musical.
They used to joke when Boeing sneezes, Seattle catches a cold.
People were leaving Seattle behind for work elsewhere, so Bob and Jim purchased a billboard ad that read, "Will the last person leaving Seattle turn out the lights?"
There was mixed reactions, like with our billboard.
I don't think we were expecting everyone to find it funny, but we also weren't trying to upset anyone.
I'm proud to be in the same conversation as the Boeing bus billboard.
Sometimes you just gotta call it like you see it.
Munchkin, I just checked the stock room and saw that we only have about 2 dozen tires left. Have you been putting the surplus somewhere else?
No, I was gonna ask you the same thing.
Why would I move them without telling you?
Wait a minute.
I knew this day would come. The day the wheel stopped turning. The day the world ended. The day the Mayans prophesied. The day my mother warned me about. We're doomed. We're running out of tires!
No!
Without tires, we're nothing. All we work for, it's over. Without tires,
who am I?
Well, they were freaking out. I ran into KJ, the other documenter in town.
Hey, how's your St. Axel Falls been?
Good. I've gotten a lot of material that's given me a great insight about the town. So, what are you doing at reinventing the wheel so late?
My day just ended. I just wanted to say hello to Didi and Anjean. They are totally groovy and super fun to be around.
Who am I?
Come on, I'll introduce you. Without tires, we have no purpose. Should we start repurposing hover cars?
Never!
Hello?
Oh, hello! Welcome to Reinventing the Wheel!
This is Casey Carter. She wanted to come in and say hello.
So, how's business doing?
Oh, it's great, you know. Ever since the factory closed, we've been running out of supply of tires.
We're not a tire town anymore, and that's okay, right? You guys can repurpose anything?
Even hover cars. You don't need tires to drive.
Yeah, but Anjean and I built this solely because this town used to revolve around tires.
You know, tires were the foundation of this shop. The shop's literally called Reinventing the Wheel.
Don't take the name so literally.
Reinventing the Wheel can mean to do something new that's never been done before. Expand your horizons. Tires help you grow, but don't let them hinder your potential.
Looking back at that moment, Casey was right. We were holding too tightly onto the past.
But for good reason, we didn't want to let go.
Nevertheless, we needed to move on.
Without forgetting where we came from.
I used to have a brother. He was nearly 10 years older than me, but you'd swear we were twins. Thick as thieves and equally as mischievous, he was my partner in crime. I was pretty young when Mom passed away. I still feel heartless thinking this, but it was like nothing changed at all in my life while everything changed for him. He quit school and dedicated his life to taking care of me, gave me the life he thought I deserved. Then I grew up. He still took care of me, even getting us some pretty solid jobs and buying an old rundown arcade. We were really happy. For the first time in our lives, it was like everything had fallen into place. Then things got bad. I don't want to go into it, but it was like this perfect world I had been dreaming of my whole life was just taken from me in an instant. I was completely alone for the first time in my life. I didn't know where to go, so I just stayed. And I've been here ever since. It's not like I don't dream. Every day I wish I could just leave and never look back, but I'm stuck. Just like this town, I'm paralyzed in some fleeting moment in time. Glory days that have long since expired. And I had accepted that until these hover people came and just flipped everything on its head. Now it's like every thought I've ever repressed is flying at me full speed. I didn't want to leave the kids. I needed time to think.
Aw, man, I think Joust is out again. Never mind.
You're just like Aunt Allie.
Haha, very funny. I'm just trying to help out around here, since no one else is.
Hey, everyone. I've got some bad news. Listen now. You're gonna have to deal with me for longer than you thought. We're not moving anymore.
Oh, that's what? Great.
Really? Why? Well, my dad is the new floor manager at HVAC. He's pretty happy about it. I knew he'd taken someone else's job, and that wasn't ideal, but I really didn't care anymore. He did what he had to for our family. I'm just relieved I won't lose you all.
That's so great! See, things aren't as bad as we thought. Megan's not moving, and our parents have jobs again.
Yeah, things are great. Our parents are miserable, but hey, that's what adulthood's all about, right?
Disappear, what do you have to say to that?
lot of things. I miss having someone to come home to every night. I miss having someone who would take care of me when I was sick. I miss that sense of comfort and security, knowing there would always be someone to look out for me. One of the things I miss the most was those nights when we'd eat dinner together. I'd come home from a long day of work to find him waiting for me on the couch with the Golden Girls on TV and a pot of spaghetti on the stove. I found out pretty early on that eating alone wasn't for me. I was having a rough time at work, and Jenna invited me into her home to have dinner with her that night. And ever since then, that place has become more of a home than my own apartment. If you're lost, it's a great place to be found. And someone else is about to learn the same.
All I'm saying is, if I were to pick holographic stop signs, should be outlawed.
That's right!
Now I know where blankets are conspiracies from.
Twinkie, why don't you tell the rest of the story? How much longer are you planning on not talking to me?
I stopped speaking to her after the protest. I was so embarrassed that she entered the raffle.
When you were 15, you didn't talk to me for a month.
That's only because you accused my school crossing guard of lying about his military experience.
I found her walking down Main Street. I think she's living up there now. I thought this was the best place to bring her.
Of course. Come in. Both of you. Twiggy, get up.
Thank you.
hired me because I was a kid with ambition and I wanted to change the world. Well, I definitely changed things, and I changed a lot of people, but I haven't really changed at all. I've changed so many of these towns, and it brought me a lot of wealth, but it never made me any happier. I was so obsessed with converting the culture of all these towns that once there was no more for me to change, I was forced to take a look at myself. Say you're only as good as your last tired town. Well, this is the last tired town. So what am I gonna do now? If the future is today, then what am I gonna be tomorrow? So where are we with the what's it called?
Oh, her and I should have the deal finalized by the end of the week.
Perfect. Now where's Kelly and why did she talk to you?
I don't really know or care.
See, maybe she's comfortable in my old office.
Mercedes, it's nice to see you.
Isn't it?
What are we all doing here?
I believe it's called trespassing, actually.
Nice to see you.
Oh, good, you're all here. Thank you for coming.
What is this about exactly?
I told them about the changes I've seen around town. About how unhappy everyone was.
What are you talking about? Folks have jobs now.
Trying to convince them that not everyone was happy was hard. To them, financial success was happiness.
You all increased everyone's salary at the factory.
We had come to this town with good intentions, but we had robbed them of their identity. To them, we took more than we gave. We didn't understand that in this town, their culture meant more than their money.
Ugh, you're being overdramatic.
Nothing I said was getting through to them, so I tried something different. Why do people mess with things they do not understand? Playing puppet master, too much power.
Just brought them down.
before we lose them forever. We can't help bring them into the future if we first don't help them honor their past.
We'll do whatever we can to help. You know, retired life was driving me crazy anyway. You have all my resources.
What about that space and time that Robbie just closed the deal on? Maybe we could use it to give back to Axel Falls.
My parents always taught me to look for the fun in otherwise dull days. Every day they drop me off and say, bye, Daisy. Remember, life's a game. I remember when I was first starting school, I had a lot of trouble making friends. But I loved to play pretend and escape this small town and go anywhere else. I was a street fighter in an urban metropolis, a queen of make-believe castles, but other kids thought I was weird. One day, my parents left a note in my lunchbox that said, do what makes you happy, and the right people will follow. So, I did just that. I looked for the games. Right down Main Street, in fact, at the arcade. That's where I met Mom. I wonder if she got a note in her lunchbox, too.
Should I even bother making any dip tonight?
It's getting late. I don't think anyone's coming.
I guess game night is officially no more. Jason, you can stop. We don't need that right now. What's wrong? You never loved having folks over for game night anyways.
It's not that. Life's just been throwing too many punches lately.
What do you mean?
Daisy goes back to college soon. Work has been terrible. I went from being in charge to taking orders. Riches to rags, am I right? Not to mention the pay cut.
We'll figure it out. We always do.
I just don't know what my purpose is anymore.
A job is not a purpose. What do you want?
I don't know.
Do you want to quit your job?
I don't know.
Do you want to move out?
I don't know.
Well, then what do you know?
All I know is that no one in Axel Falls cares about family game night anymore.
Let's fix that.
What do you mean?
Let's play a game.
The two of us? What game do you want to play?
Cybermania, Fantasy Edition.
You have never wanted to play Cybermania before.
Maybe this town isn't the only thing that's changed.
You're on.
I'll get the VR glasses.
Alright, the game mechanics are a little wonky at first, but once you understand the class system, perk tree, and energy structure...
Shut up! It's a game. I'll figure it out.
Alright, let's make you a character. You want to scroll through the character selection menu. You want someone that has a good balance of agility, strength, and stealth.
This one! I pick this one. Let's play.
Alright.
So, what exactly are we supposed to do?
If we pick this adventure, we are two peasants trying to save the hero of our kingdom. There's a maze, dragon, and a really hard final boss.
Sounds good. Let's play.
Alright.
Your hero has been captured and finds himself in danger. The fate of your kingdom rests on your shoulders.
Boss, in the middle of a world full of monsters, goblins, ugly trolls, you're stopped. In the tracks at a gate where adventure calls and evil waits unlocked. With the sword unsheathed and a sword through speed, but frank and easy, the only hope is you.
First, you must make your way through the lava labyrinth.
Quick, equip your boots of fire resistance!
Trapped in a dungeon.
together. Even whatever choice we make about our lives, as long as we make it together.
You've got one life, so choose how to play it. You're filled with fear. Do you crumble or face it? It's your last chance. Do you leave it or take it? When pressure is high, we'll survive.
Journey.
titled Hubber Brothers Puppet Pals. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Change is difficult, it's the toughest.
In that time, Axel Falls has changed beyond his wildest dreams. It took some time, but they finally got back on their feet. They might never be as prosperous as they once were, but they're doing pretty well. Recently, Kendrick Helen's Food on the Fly became a $1 billion company, cementing his revolutionary legacy in the quick service food industry.
But that's not the only surprise success story. After the event you just saw unfold, Dee Dee and Anjean turned reinventing the wheel into a museum with full support from the Hover Brothers Hover Company.
Like most things around here, it started slowly, but it really caught on in recent years because of her documentary and her reporting. The world sympathized with the story of the last tire town, and Axel Falls became a tourist trap once again.
But what happens next? We don't know. We're all caught up. Let's find out together.
So, what do you think?
We know it's a lot to digest, but we're really glad you volunteered to test drive our latest exhibit before its grand opening.
Yeah, which is in about 30 seconds, so we don't exactly have a lot of time for feedback right now. Oh, unless Bill Shoemaker has any notes. Bill?
They're coming. We have to take notes later.
People of Axel Falls, and even though it's been many years since we've been together, we still say people of Axel Falls because that's who you'll always be.
We asked you to come to look back at a pivotal time in our history when we became more than just a tire town. We lost a lot back then, but we never lost ourselves.
We created this exhibit to commemorate our past while celebrating our future. As the circle of life continues to spin, we can look forward to tomorrow as with our past as a guide.
We welcome you to look at our latest exhibit,
Yesterday, Today, and Tomorrow, here in Axel Falls.
By looking back at your place in this town's history, we can all move forward toward an exciting future.
We were born in the heart of steel. We were made just to turn these wheels round and round.
Look at what we became.